In this video, we're looking at an Atwood variant where the pulley is heavy. So I have a mass sliding down a frictionless incline. It's connected to a string wrapped around a heavy pulley with a mass of M and a radius of R. And as that mass slides down the incline, it's unwinding the pulley, but remember the pulley has some inertia now, so that slows things down. We're reminded in the problem that the formula for the moment of inertia of a disk is 1/2 mr squared. And we're kind of guided through how to find the solution to this problem. In part A, we're told to set up two equations relating tension and acceleration by applying Newton's second law, that's F equals ma, to the block. And then the purely rotating thing, the pulley, we're going to apply tau equals I alpha to that. That's the rotational equivalent of Newton's second law. We're also reminded that the relationship between linear and angular acceleration for a rotating object is A equals R alpha. And ultimately our goal here is to find the acceleration of this block as it slides down the ramp. So the first step is to get all the relevant forces into the diagram. We'll go ahead and start with the tension acting at the ends of the string. And so there's the tension acting at the edge of the disk. Here's the tension pulling up the ramp on the mass. Then the mass is also going to experience the force of gravity pulling straight down, and we want to decompose this into the standard components. And this is our standard diagram where we have gravity pulling straight down. And then the angle between the force of gravity and the perpendicular is the same as the angle of incline for the ramp. So if our force of gravity is mg, this perpendicular piece is mg cosine theta, and the parallel piece, which is the one we're concerned with, is mg sine theta. Now that perpendicular piece, that determines the normal force, but that would only matter if we had friction in this problem. All right, one last thing I want to do before I start writing down equations is to note that our disk is accelerating in the angular sense with an acceleration of alpha, and that the linear acceleration on the edge of the disk, which is the same as the acceleration of the string, is given by this relationship A equals R alpha. Now let's apply Newton's second law to the sliding block in the parallel direction. I'm going to call the actual direction of acceleration positive. So we apply Newton's second law very responsibly, starting from F net equals ma. And then our positive force here down the ramp is mg sine theta. The tension pulls up the ramp, which makes it negative. And there's our net force, and that's equal to the mass of the block times its acceleration. So there's equation number one. Now we analyze the disk and we look at the net torque on it, and that's equal to I times alpha, its angular acceleration. And there's only one force exerting a torque on this disk. It's that string pulling tangentially, and it has a radius of R from the center of rotation. Because it's coming off tangentially, that automatically makes it perpendicular, which makes torque very simple to compute. And my net torque is just T times R, and that's equal to I times alpha. This is a disk, so I is 1/2 mr squared. And then finally, instead of writing alpha, I'm going to use this relationship, A equals R alpha, and solve for alpha, that's A over R. One of those R's cancels on the right-hand side between the numerator and denominator. The other one cancels by dividing by R on both sides of the equation, so the R's are all gone. And we can clean up our system of equations. That's mg sine theta minus t equals ma, and t equals 1/2 ma. Now in part B, we want to compute the acceleration of the block in terms of g and theta. So the system of equations is already set up to use elimination. We just simply add them, and the negative t and the positive t cancel out, so one of our variables is gone. On the left-hand side, we get mg sine theta. And on the right-hand side, we get ma plus another 1/2 ma, which is 3/2 ma. Now the m's are going to cancel, and we solve for a and obtain an acceleration of 2/3 g sine theta. Now when I gave this problem on an exam, I needed a two-part question at that point in the test, so I didn't ask kind of the obvious follow-up question here. What's the tension in the string? So I want to show that real quick. All we have to do is plug in the A we just got into the second equation, and I get T equals 1/2 ma, and we've got the tension. So this is kind of our bonus for this problem. T is 1/2 ma, and I just figured out A is 2/3 g sine theta. The twos cancel. And I find a tension in the string of 1/3 mg, I can tell that's a force, so that's good, times sine theta. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.